don't forget the dessert. I think it's the most important part of a meal. I like to start with it, in fact. An executive pastry chef, Stephen Smith from Thunder Valley, is here. Look at all this you've made. You really think that we could make this?
Yeah, you know, if you
the orange cranberry bundt cake.
If you buy the mixes, you know, you can add to them. You just buy a plain mix and add flavors to them rather than try and make everything yourself. You know, just add the cranberries, the orange flavoring, different things. So you could, out of one mix, you could actually make two or three cakes.
Semi-homemade. Yeah. I like that. Okay, so you don't have to buy all the different flavors,
no,
just one.
Just
we have that recipe at KCRA.com, by the way. What else have you made here?
Well, there's a lot of, this is a rum cake, this is a bundt cake. It's made
same
with
same thing you add, it's made with 151. So same thing, you start with the basic mix and then you add the rum.
Flavors to it. Same with the lemon. The Yule log is a traditional Yule log.
This is beautiful. So how did you do that?
You make a Swiss roll, it's very thin, and then you just
roll
spread
it.
Yeah, and roll it together and make the, you know.
I like the cutting off the top of the pineapple and turning it upside down to make it a
little
tree. Okay, you're going to show us how to make these little pastries right here. Let's get to that really quick. So you start out with.
So you buy your puff pastry dough from any store.
Could be Pillsbury.
Pillsbury, whatever.
Roll it
and then
out.
You just cut out two different circles, a smaller circle and a larger circle.
Okay.
So what you do is just brush it with a little egg wash.
Just that's just egg mixed up. That's it. Okay.
Yeah, just a little egg wash. And then whatever fillings you like, you can do cherry.
Okay. What other fillings
blueberry.
Do you recommend? A blueberry, well, cherry, and what's the third one you have over there?
That's a fruit mix. It's apple. It's called mincemeat.
Ooh.
But it's made with actually all the fillings.
Do you put the big piece on top of the
on
small
the top.
Piece? Okay.
So that you put the top on. And then you just gotta cut it. Press the top down so that it's firm.
Okay, to close it.
To close it.
Okay.
Yeah. Very simple.
And how long do we bake these for?
You bake these for about 15 minutes, in about 380.
I almost just dropped the
depending
whole
thing. Depending on which, what oven you have. If you have a convection oven, obviously they're a little warmer, so you drop the temperatures down a little.
For how long? 3 minutes, you said?
No, 15.
15 minutes. Oh, okay.
15 minutes. And then when they come out, you just sprinkle with a little powdered sugar, and you've got a nice warm dessert for the table.
Wow. Can we cut this open? Oops.
Yep.
I don't want to knock everything over here so we can see what it looks like. Go ahead. All right, here we go. Let's get this. Wow, look at that inside. And it looks like a professional came to your home.
Yeah, and this is very simple for you to do. You don't even really, you know, you just brush it with a little egg wash.
Oh, on top before you put it in.
On top before you put it in the oven.
All right. Chef, thank you so much. Happy holidays to you. We're going to take a quick break. We'll be right back again. Recipes at KCRA.com.